फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू क्लास 14 ओके सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग द ऑक्सीडेटिव एडिशन ओके एंड वी केम अक्रॉस अबाउट द मेटल नेचर हाउ शुड बी द मेटल लिगैंड नेचर हाउ शुड बी द लिगैंड ओके सो वास्कास कॉम्प्लेक्स वी हैव लर्न दैट इज CrCOCl ओके PPH3 ट्राइफिनाइल फॉस्फाइन ट्वाइस So this is your Osaka's complex. Now I said this is a ligand. Okay. Now instead of PPH3, so if I take it as this compound COCl PR thrice. Okay. PR thrice like this. If I take this compound. Okay. So where R stands for any. I will substitute this R now. Okay. R I will take methyl group okay or I will take phenyl group or like here PPH3 is there so R3 so I will take as a phenyl group or I may take as methoxy group okay or I will take it as fluoride and if I ask you the order of oxidative addition okay So I will give the order of oxidative addition here. So in yesterday's video, I had given you that the oxidative addition is dependent on the ligand and which group if ligand is so that the oxidative addition is very fast, that is electron donating group. Okay. So if electron donating group is there, then what will happen? So it will donate the electron to metal and metal indirectly will have the band donation and that will help for the oxidative addition reactions, is it right? So this is what we have learned there. So that's why if you see in this order, so you know that fluorine is a highly electronegative in nature, okay, withdrawing group. Followed by this. So this is more, and that's why if R is equal to methyl is always greater than phenyl, always greater than methoxy, and final we will get fluoride. So this is the order of oxidative addition. Okay, so it is in the order of the alkyl. So this is alkyl. Okay, then it is phenyl. That is aryl. Okay, aryl stands the second, and this is methoxy alkoxide. We call it as alkoxide. Okay, and this is halide. This is a alkoxide, and this is a halide like this. So, alkyl will be always greater for the oxidative addition, followed by aryl. Then you can see alkoxide, and the halide is the least. So this is what one thing you have to keep in the mind of the oxidative addition. Now, if the electron donation, if the incoming group, I can say if the incoming group now, incoming group, okay, that is a ligand. Now there may be two types now, one is polar incoming group and one is non-polar. So what will happen, how the oxidative addition will take place here. For example, I will take same compound IRCOCl PPH3 twice, Waska's compound complex I will take, and I will add the H2 here. So what about this H2 here? H2 hydrogen is a non-polar, you know that, okay, it's a non-polar. If this is a condition, they always remember that oxidative addition, if the non-polar is taken place, so it will be always at this cis condition. So like this, if I take here, so IR, now this addition to this complex will be in cis condition, that is H here like this. Other things you can write anyway, COCl PPH3 like this, okay. So this type of addition you can see here like this, okay. So same thing here, from plus 1 iridium has gone to plus 3, you can say coordination number from 4 it has gone to 6, electron cloud also you can see from 16 to 18 like this, okay. So you can see that all the things here is been increased by 2 units, it is increased by 2 units, and that's 4, therefore it is a very good oxidative reaction here, okay. So this is what you have to keep in the mind for the non-polar. Now if we go for polar addition, similarly if I go COCl PPH3 twice plus CH3I, okay, I will go for, now this is a polar, so non-polar we went, now if we go for polar, how will be the addition takes place here? So addition will be always trans, this you have to keep in the mind. So addition will be now trans, this is iridium, so if I take it as CH3, I will take it here, I here, then other things you can write COCl PPH3 and here P, PH, like this, okay. So this type of addition you can see if it is in trans condition like this. So this is some of the concepts I can say in oxidative addition reactions, okay. So like this. Now we'll go for the next concept, that is reductive elimination. So next we'll go for reductive elimination. Okay. In future, this one we'll see if any more questions or any more concepts if I get for oxidative addition, I will add. Okay, don't worry. So this is more than sufficient to understand the concept of oxidative addition reaction. Okay, so next we will see of the reductive elimination here. So what is, I said you before only, it's a reverse of oxidative addition. It is a reverse of oxidative addition. So what happens here? So if you take here ligand here, okay, and LM, and you join this here with two ligands, okay. So what will happen here? This AB will go, okay, and you are going to get LNM. So like this, okay. So this is how you can see that. Now in this reductive elimination, see here, so it was having two ligands attached to here, but ligand will be eliminated here and you get the metal. And that means if you see the metal here, so it is reverse of the oxidative addition. That means now in this case what is happening, the coordination number is decreased again by 2 units, reverse I said. Then if you see the electron count also decreases by 2 unit. If it is 16, it comes to 14 like this, okay. So 2 units it is decreasing electron count. Oxidation state also decreases by 2 units, that means from +3 to +1 again. So like this. So this is what about the condition here. Now what happens here if you see, so here if I take it as L metal here and A and B here, so what will happen here now? This will go here, so like this, and it will go the A, okay, will give the electron and go here with the form. So metal will get here negative charge, okay. Now what will happen, B will next, what will happen, B will go here and by taking the electron, and we get B minus here, okay. And when the B will go, so it will become a positive charge. So plus minus whatever the generation will be there, so that it is going to form the neutral, this one. And here also plus A is gone and minus is gone, so they both will react with each other to form the AB like this. That's why they get eliminated and you are going to get back your metal. This is what happens in here, okay. Now if you see the conditions here for reductive elimination, the conditions, what are like oxidative additions, you have taken conditions for metal and ligands, everything. The same thing here, if you take the conditions, so here metal should be electron deficient, reverse as I said. So here metal should be electron deficient, this is very much important, the electron deficient, okay. So how should be the ligand? Ligand should be pi acceptors, so ligand should be very good pi acceptor. So if it is pi acceptor, so what will happen? So they will favor the rate of reduction. So rate of reduction elimination, rate of reduction elimination is increased, okay. So this is what you have to keep in the mind. Second point, that ligand should be very good pi acceptor. If you see the third point here, the elimination of AB, whatever the elimination is there, so this is eliminated, okay. So this elimination, whatever product is going to form, they should be highly stable. This is very much important, okay. The product form should be very good stable, okay. So this is what about this should be kept in the point. And fourth point you have to keep in the point is eliminated product. So whatever the eliminated reactant is there, they should be cis to each other, okay. They should be cis to each, they should stand cis, not trans, okay. So they should be cis, kept cis, like here we have shown it here. So we have taken this metal and we have shown this A and B like this, okay. So not A and B like this, so this is not possible, only cis to each other. So when we keep this cis, then only the product, this will be eliminated, otherwise it is not eliminated. So this thing you have to keep in the mind. Now if I ask you like for some example, I will take as a metal here, I will place this two group here, okay, phenyl phosphine, okay, PPH3 like this. And if I add some reactant here and if I heat, so can you get the eliminated product here? So any product elimination is going to happen here. So there is a no. Why it is not? Because whatever the eliminated product should be, so it should be, it is trans here, okay? This is not going to eliminate. Now this, there is a chance of going to elimination this, but this product is not stable. So that is what I said you, okay? So eliminated product should be stable, then only it is going to eliminate. Is it right? This is stable, ethane gas, C2H6, this is stable, but they are, how? They are trans to each other. That's why this is not stable. But however, if I add CH3I, okay, to this compound only, now what will happen? This will have here CH3, and since this is, I said, trans to each other, so you will CH3 and it will add trans to each other like this, and remaining this ligand is like this. Now it is possible any reduction. Same condition I will add here, condition I will put same here, heat or something like that, condition is same here. So what, can you tell me what is going? Yes, now it is going to eliminate cis to each other. So now this is going to eliminate C2H6, that is CH3CH2. This is going, ethane gas is going to be eliminated, and this is very, very stable. So like this, okay? So this is how we can say, we can show that reductive elimination is possible, okay? So this is what about the best example. As I said, it's a totally reverse of your oxidative addition. So like this, in one case, simple questions they will ask in the examination of oxidative addition and reductive elimination. So whatever we have given, or even Waskas complex also, yesterday's what we had given of addition of IR, CO, Cl, PPH3, PPH3 twice, okay? When you put it H2, so what will happen now? So this is going to form IR, EH, CO, Cl, PPH3, PH3, see now, like this. So if I go like this, it is oxidative addition now. So everything is, you can say, like this. If I go in this way, it is become reductive elimination, like this, reverse. Okay, this also example for reductive elimination. This also example. Metal, you can take anything, palladium or platinum, something like that for this case, okay? So this is how, or even iridium, like this. So this is how we can show the example of reductive elimination. Now in this case only, two important concepts come in this concept here. That is migratory insertion. One more thing you have to keep in mind, because catalysis we are learning, so in future we require all these terms to be included into the catalysis process, okay? So migratory insertion, this one word will come, and one more thing it comes, beta elimination. This is very much important, okay? Migratory insertion and beta elimination. So beta elimination means what? Here the beta elimination is, that is hydride. So beta H elimination, this you have to keep in the mind. So if you take this any compound here, so like this, okay? So you can take any compound here, okay? So what will happen here now? If you take here metal, and this becomes now here alpha, and this becomes beta, and you take here hydrogen, okay? So now this beta hydrogen, whatever it is here, now it will be eliminated. This is what, okay? And metal is here and hydrogen is here. So what will happen now? This will be eliminated and this will react with the metal, okay? And the metal bond, whatever is there, it will go back here, okay? So it will go back here, and this is, you can take it as hydrogen only, okay? This also hydrogen, we'll take it as a hydrogen only here, okay? This also hydrogen, and this also hydrogen. Now what will happen? So this bond will break here, M plus, and this will break as a H minus, okay? This will break as a H minus, and you are going to get here now M plus H minus, and they are going to form the bond here, forming MH plus, whatever, what is happening here now? So since it has released here, so you are going to get the double bond here, okay? So we are going to get the double bond. Instead of this, you take it as single, like this, okay? This you remove it here, okay? So you take CC carbon, it's a sp3 hybridized here. So this only, then only I can go for the double bond here. So I will get a double bond here like this, okay? Here when it goes here, it will give double bond here, and other things will be as usual. So here hydrogen, here plus MH, like this. So I'm going to get this compound, okay? So that is what your ethylene compound. So I'm going to get your thin compound like this, okay, and this is very stable and this is very stable like this. So this type of elimination we call it as a beta elimination. So this thing you have to keep in the mind, and this happens only because of the electronegativity. So if you take the metal having 1.6 electronegativity always, okay, around 1.6, but if you take hydrogen, so it is 2.1 electronegativity, and the difference is little bit good here. So if you compare the metal and carbon, okay, so metal and carbon, what happens, metal 1.6, but what is the carbon? Carbon is 2.5, so difference is more here. So that's why always the energy here, the driving force is always here. Why? Metal carbon is having less than the metal hydride, so MH is very strong because that electronegative difference is less. So this is a this is strong, and that is a driving force for forming the metal hydride, MH, for forming the MH bond here. So this thing you have to keep in the mind. Now coming to the next concept of this, okay, so we will see the next this one. Okay, so this is what about the beta hydride elimination. And usually during this beta hydride elimination, the simple product we are going to get is the olefin compounds. Okay, this is what very much important, very stable, so they are more stable. But sometimes if in the examination, if they give you stable compound itself and ask you for the beta hydride elimination, then it is not possible. The compound should not be stable. Whatever given compound is reactant is there, it should be not stable. If it is stable, then beta hydride is not possible. Even though there is beta hydrogen is there, but it is not possible if the compound given is stable, is it right? If it is not stable, definitely it will beta hydride will take place, elimination will take place. So you should study the compound also, so that is very much important. Okay, so this is what. So beta position, the main criteria is that should at the beta position there should be hydride ion. Okay, this is the main condition, that should be hydride ion, hydrogen should be there. Okay, and this is the main condition here for the beta elimination. Okay, and metal and hydrogen, always whatever the metal and hydrogen is present, they should be syn position. Okay, syn, and syn means cis position, they should be present at the cis position, like I already told now. So if it is like this, okay, so here metal, so here should be H, like this, it should be placed like this. This is called syn position. Okay, so not other anti position like that. So that will not give you elimination here. And the next thing is what, always about, if you see the electron count, 16 electron system, okay, should be present always. Okay, this is important because we are learning the reductive elimination. The 16 electron species should be there, because if 18 electron species or more than 16, if we take, for example, if 18 electron, if you take the complex, or more than 16 electron, if you take, what will happen? That will undergo dissociation. That is important. That will undergo the dissociation first. Okay, so that is and become the 16 electron. This we don't require. So dissociation, then it becomes the 16 electron, and then the beta hydride elimination takes place. Beta hydride elimination takes place. So this is what happened. That's why better is 16 electron. 16 electron is good. If it is more than that, definitely beta hydride will take place. But first it was under dissociation. It will go dissociate and get into 16. Then the beta hydride elimination will takes place. So this you have to keep in the mind. Okay, and if you see that if the compound is if it is stable, then it is not possible, beta hydride will be absent. Okay, so that is you have to keep in the mind. Okay, now if you come at the note here, so what shall we go for the note here? So usually if carbon is sp2 hybridized or sp3 hybridized type, so this you have to see. And if the complex is stable here, okay, if the carbon stands with sp2 or sp3 and with stable this one, so there will be no beta hydride elimination. There will be no beta hydride elimination. Okay, so this thing you have to keep in the mind, because they don't lie. Sometimes if sp2 is there, they don't lie in the same plane. Okay, so that is a possibility. And second thing was, after, if we go for beta hydride elimination also, the formed product should be stable. The formed product, whatever is going to form, should be stable, then only the beta hydride will take place. Okay, after beta hydride, if the formed product is not stable, then this will not happen. Beta hydride will not take place. Okay, so these things you have to keep in the mind. sp2 sp3 hybridized and as well as the product formed. Okay, this thing, that's why as we go for some examples and all, we will understand more here for beta hydride elimination. Okay, now for example, if I take tungsten and I attach the octahedral structure with all CH3 group here, CH3 group, definitely. Okay, now if I take it as alpha beta like that, so definitely for beta hydride is there, hydrogen is there, so can I go for this beta hydride elimination? So it is not possible. Why? Because this is stable. Okay, tungsten hexa methyl is a stable compound, and I cannot go for the beta hydride elimination for this. Okay, similarly, if I take the compound like you take some palladium like this, palladium, okay, like this. Okay, now if I ask you beta hydride elimination in which case I am going to get the beta hydride, because this is a 4-membered ring, so 1 2 3, okay, 3 carbon, and here it is 5, 1 2 3 4 5 carbon, 5-membered ring is there here, 4-membered ring is there. Okay, now if I ask you if which is more stable here, so definitely this compound has to be more stable than the this one, is it right? Because of the angle strain and all, so this is more stable than this. I ask, this is how the stability I can show it, can be revealed here. But if I ask you now which is having more beta hydride elimination in both the case, because now if you see in this case also, this is alpha and this is beta, so there is hydrogen here, is it right? So here also same thing, this is alpha and this is beta, so here also hydride is there. So but this is a more stable component, that's why if I ask you which having the beta beta hydride elimination is, if I take it as a compound and B compound, which is highest, definitely this will be having the highest beta hydride elimination, because this is stability wise this is more stable, but elimination wise this will be more favored for the elimination. So this is how in this examination, in this example, you can come to know the beta hydride elimination is totally depends on the on the complexes as well as the nature of the carbon hybridization as well as the formation of the stable compound or unstable compound. These all things will carry in this beta hydride elimination. Okay, so this is what about the elimination or beta hydride elimination type condition. Okay, so next will be insertion. So what is that? Migratory insertion. So elimination is over, one example we'll learn more on that hydride elimination. So migratory elimination, so what is the migratory elimination? One case here y will be there, and here x, if I take it here, so what will happen now? This x will migrate here, okay, and I am going to get now here what, vacant place here, and x has migrated here, so I am going to write here x. Now see here, now if I treat this with ligand here, now any of the ligand, what will happen? This ligand will take the place of this vacant place, and I am going to get here now ligand, and here I am going to get x, and here I am going to get y, like this, or y and here x, like this. Okay, so this type of this we call it as a migratory insertion. So migratory insertion, this has been inserted here, okay, and you are getting this new compound. This type of this we call it as a migratory insertion here. So some condition apply here. Now what is the condition applied here? See here y, okay, so what about this y? This should be unsaturated, because it has to attach with this incoming ligand here, therefore whatever this y is there, this should be unsaturated. This is a condition. Okay, so it has to apply unsaturated, means double bond, triple bond, something like that, triple bond, double bond. So this type of any ligands are there, so you can see that they welcome, okay, they welcome the this is a condition for y, then only it will welcome for the another ligand migratory insertion, and it becomes this bond will break. So this is what happens here, this is what very much important. Okay, multiple bonds is very much important here. Okay, so unsaturation is very much important in this case. Okay, so this is what, and second thing to be inserted here, the point you have to remember is here, the group inserted, they should lie cis. Okay, So whatever C and I have written a C group, which is should be inserted here, they should lie cyst in the nature, okay, not trans, okay. So this is very much important here. So they should be cyst, not trans. Then only the insertion takes place here, okay. So this is what about the concept of brief concept of the migratory insertion and the total reductive elimination apart from this oxidative addition and oxidative addition. So this is what in today's class we have learned in this video, okay. So in the next video I will see if I get more concepts on this reductive elimination as well as migratory insertion. I will add into that and we will see in the next video. Thank you.